Score 11 out of Primary 6 from Yiming Primary School. In this lesson, we'll continue with Calculus, Chapter 7, Double and Triple Integral. So for this double and triple integral, the past few lessons, we have done a question. And for this question, it's written here, we've used four methods. First method, the simplest, polar coordinates. Second method, we have trigonal substitution. Third method, we have integral back with respect to x first. Then it's integral back with respect to y first. So now let's take a look at the method that we'll be using. And just to tell you that there is also substitution. So for this fifth method, so this method number 5, we also have trigonal substitution. But for this, because the first trigonal substitution is with respect to y first, so now this is with respect to x first. Like this. Okay, so for this, let's first see. So in this question, that is a double integral, and your integral boundary is x squared plus y squared is equal to 2x, and x is bigger or equals to 1. And you have dx dy over bracket x squared plus y squared, and then a square. So for this, a formula that we need to use, that is we have the over x squared plus y squared and then the square. We've proven this before. And for this formula, that is and this formula is something like this. Just that because this is indefinite integral, so we have a C. But now this is a definite integral. And so that means we'll have a boundary. So that means we'll need to draw what the integral region is like. So we have proven before that this is a circle. Okay, so for this circle, it is touching the y-axis, and its center, that is over here. The x-axis passes it. And this center, okay, here's the origin, is at 1. So that means we'll need this part. Like this. So this is the region that we are finding. Now let's see. So we x first. So when it is x first, so then it's x, it goes from 1 all the way to, so for this, we've used completing square. And what we got is something like this. So we can just move this there. So right now, the problem is whether plus or minus. But this is simple because minus is on this side, plus is on the other side. So that means this will go all the way to 1 plus square root 1 minus y squared. Like this. Then the boundary for y, since you already have these, I mean like this, yeah. That means it's just from negative 1 all the way to 1, as its radius is a 1. So now, at this part, here is a little bit special. Why special? You see, negative 1 all the way to 1. You realize that it is symmetric about the x-axis. So that means this part below and that part above, we can just use 2 times. What I mean is that we can just change this 0 to 1, then times the 2. Okay, like this is also the same. So now we need to use this formula. So that means a half and a 2, they will just simplify. But we do have a 1 over y cubed. Yeah. Then inside we have inverse tangent x over y plus xy. Then you over x squared plus y squared. Then for this, you need to start from 1 all the way to 1 plus square root 1 minus y squared. Like this. Then you have a dy. So this we don't need right now. We've already used it. So that means at this part, let's see. We can sub them in. Okay. So this part's just subbing in. Well, when subbing in, you can actually just expand them at the same time. And sometimes you can just combine. Like this. Now here comes the different part, because for the first trigonal substitution, we just work these out separately, but now we can just combine them to work with. So that means we need to use another formula here. Okay, so in this case, I'll just use alpha and beta. Here we have a minus. So this is inverse tangent that will have alpha. So here is a minus beta that will over the 1 plus alpha times beta, like this. So that is a formula that we'll need to use to combine these two inverse tangents. So alpha minus beta. Then over 1 plus alpha times beta. So like this. Then next here is a plus whatever. So right now at this part, well, we can actually just simplify something by a little bit. So you realize that you can just factorize y first and a 2 here first. Then you realize 1 plus square root 1 minus y square, 1 plus square root 1 minus y square. So maybe I'll just separate them. So that means this first part is here. Then the second part. Because all these 1 plus this is simplified, so you're left with this. Then you have to minus. Now here for this part, oh wait, 1 over y cubed. So minus, you still have integrate from 0 to 1, then it's a 1 over y cubed. So now at this part, y over y squared plus 1. Well, first write it like this, later we can simplify. Okay, so let's see, back to this part. You realize we can still common denominator and then simplify. Like this. And then, at this part, 1. Minus a 1, we just cancel that out. So here's the square root 1 over y squared. But when you common denominator, y squared, simplify, 1 y goes up. And here will become 1 plus y squared plus square root 1 minus y squared. Like this. And then dy. Then we'll pass. So I'm gonna see at this part. Simplify. And also the half we can put it in front. So it becomes like this. Then minus integral from 0 to 1. Then 1 over y squared times y squared plus 1 dy, like this. So next, this would be equal to, so the first part, well, we have all these things. It would be quite hard to just work all these out. So let's see, can we just put 1 over y cubed inside this dy? is actually, that's what we said it as, integral back. It's just like putting one part of the integrand inside a D, like that. And this is just integrating. Well, those extras, you put it either in the integrand as a variable, or you put it outside as the sign, positive, negative, or the constant. So let's see, in this case, it becomes 1 over y squared. So that means we have a negative half. So negative is the sign, half is a constant. And then we don't have any new variables. So wait. There. So next, at this part, well, we can integrate it already. So that means we have an extra negative. And here's a 1 over y. So there, we'll integrate from 0 all the way to 1. And then at this next part, you see 1 plus y squared. That means here above, you can plus a y squared, then you can minus a y squared. Like this. And then next. So when we see at this part, well, we can't integrate, we'll use integral by parts. So when we use this integral by parts, wait, for the first part we don't have, we just have over y squared times this inside. So it becomes like this. Then at this part, so when we sum in 1, it becomes a half. When we sum in 0, wait, get an infinity. That means we need to put it into the limit. Oh wait, how about that integral by parts? So here I just change it a little bit. So that means we'll plus a half. Then at this part, this is in the integrand. So let's see at this part, we'll need to differentiate to take this out from that D. So when we differentiate, we'll take that out. Well, this is a bit tricky here, so we can just connect them together. So let's see what will this become. So that means it's this thing squared. Then you plus a 1, like this, and then next, inside here, the chain rule, so, then we also need to use the quotient rule. So, first let's look at the numerator, let's try to differentiate it. Well, that means we also have to use another term of the product rule for the numerator because there's a times. So first, when we see it, that y. Y, nothing happens. Then x is the square root 4 minus y squared. Another term of the chain rule. That means here plus. So when this happens, you'll need down here 2 square root 1 minus y squared. So 1 minus y squared, the negative y squared. Up here is a negative 2y. Okay, then you need to times what you have in the denominator. And then we'll need to differentiate this denominator. So here becomes a minus. So when we differentiate this denominator, we'll have so 1 constant 0. Then it's the y squared, that is a 2y. And square root 1 minus y squared. Chain rule. So you see here, sometimes we need them multiple times. So because here it's just a time, so we don't need a bracket. Like this, and then our denominator, this thing, square. Put it down here. So this is quite a long chain of them. Then here's dy. So now we can look at this part. So of course here's a minus half. Then the other part is going to the limit. Then here. Separate them. So we'll just separate them and I can just write this below there. So let's see, well, we separate them. Well, now what happens? So first thing, simplify. Like this. Okay, so we have this, then our limit. So this is just a positive half over y. Okay, so we have something like this. So now we can sub in. So I'll write that on this part. So here, let's see, minus. Okay, so I'll just write the above first. So this is equal to a negative. So let's see. When 1 is not in, you have a half. Half times inverse tangent 1, 0. So that means inverse tangent is a 0. So inverse tangent is 0, that means this is a 0. And that means the whole thing is a 0. But if you start in 0, here, nope, infinity, put it inside a limit 2. So first thing, the 0. Then now let's see, how about this second part, this whole chain of things? So let's see. Now we can common denominator while simplifying. Common denominator. So let's try. Well, we common denominator. just becomes a minus. And number two, simplify. So then times, oh wait a second, here this part also have a Y, and that means, yeah, it came from here, so that means this part this one don't have. Let me get a square. Then we have 1 plus y square plus square root 1 minus y square. Then here also common denominator. Yep, like this, then you over. So that means because both these denominators are the same, that is square root 1 minus y square. So you can just take that below. That means you will have y square times square root 1 minus y square. Then you have the times. So at this part, also common denominator. Then be careful. When you are in the common denominator, you'll realize this is the same. So just simplify that. You don't need to write those repeats anymore. So let's see. You would have y square, square root of that. So that means here we'll use square brackets. Yup. And then this part is this thing square. That means we have to plus this square. Like this. Then next, we'll need to expand this. Expand. Okay. So that means this is just 1 minus 2y squared. So it becomes like that. So let's see here. We'll have 1. Then here, when at first it is a plus y squared, you have a minus 2 of them. That means you're minus 1 of it. Then one of this. And that means here, minus 2y to the power of 4. You have to minus 2y square of the square root 1 minus y square. And then you have to minus, so this part, you'll erase this to, in order not to get confused. Then, the second part. Well, this second part, we can also try to expand it. So it'll become 2y squared. Then you'll plus, let's see, we'll have 2y to the power of 4. Then plus y squared, square root 1 minus y squared. Like this. Then we'll have to over. So then this part expansion. So let's see, this part we might also be able to expand it. So we'll plus 1, 2 of those. Okay, so first I'll write out those squares. The next comes in 2y square plus 2 square root 1 minus y square. Like this. And then next, we're trying to combine the things. One stays there. So y square, 2y square, and no more, 3y square. And it's a minus. So next here is this part, nothing else to combine with. So let's see, how about this? Oh, we can combine it with this part. That means it's still a negative y square on this. Then how about at the denominator? So this denominator part will have y square times square root 1 minus y square. Then we'll have the times, so let's see. And also these two simplify. So y square and y square. But here's another y square. So one of this y square, then we'll have here, oh wait a second, we'll have another three of them. Okay, then we'll have these four. Then it's plus 2 square root 1 minus y square. Okay, and then next. So after this, okay, like this. So I just have a double check to see whether there are any mistakes. Okay, so next, at this part, was kind of strange here. In a 2 and a 2. Oh wait, I get it. This part. No wonder, it's a square of that. Okay, that's more like it. So that means here we'll just these two cancel, two of them. Okay, yup. So that means here we'll also have two of them. Oh wait, they cancel. Seriously? Okay, they canceled. So that means we'll have plus 2 of this, and then plus another 2 of this. Like this. 1 plus 1. Okay, so that means we'll be able to take out 2 first. Then next, we'll look at these parts. So 2 can be with this. That means we can have, okay. From these two, we can just factorize square roots 1 minus y squared. Here we'll use square brackets. Like this. And then next, so here are these two, we can just factorize them out. So when we factorize them out, we'll have another 1 plus square root or minus y squared. So we have something like this. And then after that, so that means in this part, we'll have something like this. Okay, so we'll have something like this. And so this 2 we can put on the outside first. Like this, and then you have a minus half and then minus this. So first erase these parts. this is a minus. Okay, and then we'll have something like this. Then at this part, it just becomes inverse tangent. Wait a second. Oh wait, so this part inverse tangent. So that means we can both have a half on the outside. Like this, and then next for this part, well, that will be a big problem. So this part, well, okay, so let's see, right at this part, 1 minus y squared and another 1 minus y squared, we can have both together. Okay, so we'll use that for later. So let's see here, plus 1 over 1, when we first start in a 1, it becomes a plus 1. Then the rest with a 0, it goes inside. Then plus inside here, inverse tangent 1, that is the pi over 4. Then we'll have plus half. Here we have limit y approaches to 0 plus. than 1 over y. That means we'll have to minus 2 over y. That means you have a negative 1 over y. That will plus 1 over y squared. Inverse tangent still these things. Like this. And then next, so we have something like this. And then next, well, can we just separate them? Let's try. So that means when we separate them, we can have, well, these two can simplify first. So that means these two simplify. Oh wait, and also square root. So it becomes like this. And then next. So that means it's the power with the negative 2y squared. It will become a negative half. Then you integrate from 0 to 1. And you see, y squared simplified. Oh well, nothing left, just a 1 in the numerator. Still have all these things. First, we have like this. Oh, wait, and this bracket. So for this negative, go behind. So that means we'll put this thing first. the next one, right there. So let's see here. So then this, at that part, the square root 1 minus y square over y square times 1 plus y square. So that part, well, it's a little bit tricky there. Well, that might mean that we might need substitution there. So as here, method is already trigonal substitution, we'll have to think of which trigonal should we use. Is it sine, is it cosine, is it tangent, cotangent, or whatever. So let's see here. Well, we have square roots here, but this part, we can use sine or cosine. But if you want this part, then it's a tangent or cotangent. So let's see. Well, I might want to use the sine. So let me just write this below. I can just let y be sine theta. So that because we don't need to change it back as this indefinite integral. So this dy that is cosine theta d theta. Then so y, it is from 0 to 1. That will mean theta would be, so 0, when you start that in, still a 0. Then, when it is a 1, start that in, that's a half pi. Like this. So from this part, this would be equal to, so 1/4, still there, integrate from 0 to 1, I mean half pi. So there, square root 1 minus sine square theta, using that trigonal identity, is the cosine square theta, but because it's a square root, so it changes to cosine theta. But because here's another cosine theta, so it becomes cosine square theta. So it becomes like this. And then at this part, minus half integrated from 0 to, well, with this part, would we also use the same substitution? Well, we might also need it because here, at this part, it can just change into, well, cosine, and then cosine simplified. So we'll also use the same. So let's see here, d theta, then 1 plus sine squared theta. Then is, okay, that part is simplified. So this next is the 1 plus cosine theta. And still plus half and pi over 4. And also all these. like this. And then next, so at this part, now there's another hard part. So cosine squared theta over these things. So now that problem is, what should we change it into? So at this part, we need to find a way to change this. So in order to change this, wait, so for this first part, well, the first part, we're just writing the same way. And then for this part, what we can try is like the numerator and denominator both times 1 minus cosine theta. So that means down here we'll have a 1 minus cosine squared theta, and that gives us a sine squared theta. So up here is still minus. Like this. So at this part, the cosine squared theta, we can just change it to a 1 minus sine squared theta. And then we change that. Then the next thing we'll think of is to separate them. But the problem here at this part is that, can we just separate them already? Okay, let's try. Then here it is plus. So actually for this cosine, I can just try to go into that dx maybe. Or maybe we'll just leave it there first. like this, and then next. So we also separate for this part. So simplify that. So for this part and that part, we can just minus, and that will just create a negative. A negative here. So that means this part combined. Then next the problem is this part. So can we just change the signs for theta? Well, that doesn't sound right. So maybe we could try another way. So for this. So wait, let me see. Okay, so here is actually a little trick. Because we want to try to simplify. So maybe we can times this thing there. Then because at first we only have this one, so that means we need to minus the cosine theta times the sine square theta. Yeah, that's a trick there. Well, I just wrote it the inverse way. Okay, I'll just write it there. But first, there. Well, it's a limit, I mean. Okay, so then for this, well, let's see. This part is a little bit more tricky, but there's always a trick. As we said, if there's a will, there's a way. So let's see, what is this way. So know that here we have a 1, right? So for this 1, well, you just add a sine square theta, then you can minus a sine square theta. That's a way. So let's see here. So this can be equal to negative 1/4. Then integrate from 0 to 1/2 pi. Then, okay, 1 plus sine square theta. And then you have to minus a sine square theta. Like this. Then you can just over. So let's see, we have sine square theta times 1 plus sine square theta. Okay. Sine square theta times 1 plus sine square theta. Okay. So then, this part, it seems weird, but we can just leave it there first, because later we might be able to cancel it out. Maybe. So now let's see here. What do we have? So here's a minus. Okay, just leave it there. Don't care about that first. Because you can see from here, this part you simplify it in order to get that, but then you have an extra negative. So that means you just cancel out. Am I right? So then next, the problem is this part. Well, this part we can separate them. Or we can try. So if we separate them, we'll have cosine theta over sine square theta, then minus a cosine theta over the 1 plus sine square theta. Right, you will try that. That means after that, we'll just put a cosine theta inside the d theta. That'll be simple. Okay. Then is the half and the pi over 4, these things. Okay, so next, well, at this part, of course, separating it. So let's see what happens when we separate it first. These two simplify d theta over sine square theta. That means this is the half angle formula. Well, we might be able to use that. Or maybe we can just try something else if we can't use it. And then at this part, simplified, and I mean canceled. So at this part, oh wait a second, part over 2 here actually. Like this. Then the next part, we can just put cosine theta inside the d theta. Like this. But let me just tell you, if you want to say half angle, double angle, I'll tell you no. So what would we use? Did you realize that it's a cosecant? That means cosecant becomes cotangent. Cos. Like this, and then after that, so let's see, as I said before, it will become a cotangent, but luckily there's a negative, so it's just a positive cotangent there. So positive, don't need to write. Like this, then we can, so at this part, it's just like thinking dx over x squared, just something thinking like that. So that means we'll just have an actual negative here, and then 1 over this. Like this, or else, like at this part, let's just think again, x over 1 plus x squared. Now what is that? Wait, isn't it the tangent inverse, or also known as the inverse tangent? So, inverse tangent here. And then we'll have a sine theta. Weird. Like this. Then next, plus half plus pi over 4. And then this thing is still there. Like this, yeah, we can have it like that. Then just calculate all of them out. That would be tricky. So now, no worries, let's see. Now cotangent half pi. Let's just think, cosine half pi over sine half pi, that gives us a zero, never mind. What if it is a cotangent zero? That means it's a cosine zero over sine zero. Put it inside. It's an infinity. So that means first thing don't have. Then next, how about this? We have a half pi at the sine at the denominator. So sine half pi, that is a 1. That means first thing is a negative half. Then if it is a 0, go inside the limit. Oh, wait a second. These two cancel. Don't have. Now let's see. Half pi, put it inside. We'll have a pi over 8 minus that pi over 8. Because pi over 8, because I include the half. So pi over 8. Well, that means we'll still be left with the pi over 8. Nice. So that means next time, half limit. Now it changes. Theta approaches to 0 plus. That means these things, we also need something in here. So let's start those in. So this becomes a cosine. Here's a sine square. Then here's another cosine. Then, okay, 1 over the sine. Then next, so what do we have now? Okay, the cosine is a new one that go in. I mean, cotangent. So that means we'll have a minus because it's for cotangent zero. So I just go the other side. So that means this will need to minus. So let me see. Cotangent zero. Okay, because we already have a half, so that means here is still a half. Well, cotangent is a cosine over sine. Yeah, something like that. And then this is also a new one that go in. So half is already taken out, but it's a zero, so that means it's a plus. So, yeah. Okay. Oh, wait. There you go. Then you realize, wait a second. Cancel. So we'll have to continue with this. That means all these suck. So like this. Now what happens is, now this thing is a very special thing. We need to use the special limit. But this type of special limit, it is that inverse tangent can just over something becoming a 1. Now let's see what that thing exactly is. So that means here we need a 1/4 because here's still another half. So that means here we'll have an extra 2. we can just divide it like this. And then because we divide it, so we need to times it. And now the thing about this special limit is that there have different forms, and this kind of form, it just becomes a one. Yeah. Oops, no more half. Like this. Then next, here we still have a pi over 8. Then, so this part, we don't need to care about that already. So 2 of this. Oh, that's a lot. So let's see about this. We have a 2 cosine theta. Sine theta over sine squared theta times. Okay, so that means all of these signs will be able to simplify it. Oh no. Okay, so let me just rewrite this. And inside here, the sign, maybe just put it there still. Like this. Then that would mean, wait a second, both of them have a sine theta over, I mean, cosine theta over sine theta. Take that out. Now this is a law of changing. Oh wait, no more sign down here. So it becomes like this, and then common denominator. Don't need square bracket now. Like this. So now let's see. So pi over 8, then we can just plus. So 1/4 limit theta approaches to 0 plus. That means it's a 1 minus these. But for this cosine theta, well, and also because we are left with a 1 there, 1, we can just change it to a sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta. That means we would have something like this. And then we can just factorize another of this square. Then, here we can already sub that in. This whole thing, we can sub that in. So that means this part is a 1. Here, well, what do we have here? Here is a 1. I mean, 2. So it becomes a 1 over 8. So that means what we'll be left with is here cosine theta minus 1. Then you'll have 2 over sine theta. So let's see, we can use L'Hopital's rule. Numerator, denominator, differentiate. So let's see. 8 over pi, I mean pi over 8, Okay. It became like this. 0 over 1. 0. Answer is pi over 8. And that is the answer that we also got for the last four methods. Am I right? Okay, so you see, for this, with the not so good method, you need to work so long. Okay, but it is still a way to check whether your answers are right. Okay, so in this lesson, we can end here first. So see, we have used a lot of these trigonal things. They are really useful. So then we will have to know about these trigonal identities. We'll have to know about these, well, all sorts of things. Okay, so are you clear so far in this lesson? Okay, so we'll see you in the next lesson, and this is it, calculus, chapter 7, double and triple integration, or integral. So, if you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Hope you like our videos. See you in the next lesson. Thank you for your watching.